take advantage of a depleted defense corps and beat the Islanders. There is no rest for the weary tonight as the Islanders face the world's greatest player. He's no stranger to New York, and the Islanders have felt the sting of his Midas touch before. Now, after a year away from the game, Mario Lemieux is rested and healthy and ready to take on the Islanders. Up next. Islanders and Pittsburgh Penguins meeting for the first time this year. And you mentioned Ron Francis, who is the tremendous asset to the Pittsburgh Penguins, with Mario Lemieux, of course, as the number one center, taking all of the pressure off of him. You look at our GMC goaltending matchup. Tom Barrasso gets the start tonight. How about his number two guy, the backup, Ken Reger, was great last year.
Winningest goaltender in the NHL, but Tom Barrasso is their guy, and he's going to be establishing that over the next few weeks. Again, not having played only a couple of games last year, Tommy Soderstrom, the Islanders, trying to establish he as their number one goaltender.
Islanders getting their first look at referee Bill McCreary this season, and it's a bit of a shakeup now as far as the forward lines are concerned, at least for this first shift, as Wendell Clark plays the left wing with Travis Green and Todd Bertuzzi. So we'll see where Zygmunt Palfy winds up. The Ron Francis unit on for Pittsburgh as Bertuzzi takes control from the red line and shoots it in. On defense for the Islanders, Scott Lachance, and not Matthew Schneider, but Bob Deers, just recalled from Utah, but with the suspension to Brent Severin. And here's Jaromir Jagr, number 68, gaining the Islander zone. He's in! Has a shot stopped, and then Smolinski lifted one wide, and right away, Bob Deers tested, and a penalty coming up, an interference call, as Smolinski is the guy down on the corner.
What a move by
Jaromir Jagr.
Mario Jr., that works.
Well, he patterns himself after Mario Lemieux, as Smolinski gets up slowly. Let's take a look. Here he is against Scott Lachance, a one-on-one. Pretty good matchup. Look at this. Fakes inside, goes outside. Boom. Good stuff by Tommy Soderstrom on the rebound. Over the top of the net, Smolinski. Easily could have been down 1-0 already. First shift of the hockey game. Scott Lachance, an interference penalty. Power play for Pittsburgh.
Just 33 seconds in, the Islanders last night faced five of Philadelphia Flyer power plays and stopped them all. As you look at Scott Lachance, who normally, as we mentioned, is paired with Matthew Schneider. Right now, Schneider is out for this penalty kill, at least the first portion, with Dennis Vasky on defense. Chris Luongo scratched tonight. Dean Chenault in. We'll get to the rest of the scratches as we move along. But right now, the Islanders clear the zone as Dennis Vasky shoots it all the way down. We'll set the Penguin power play up for you. Ron Francis is the center. They've got Jagr and Sandstrom up front along with Lemieux. Francis can play the point. Jagr can play the point. See how they organize themselves as they get the dump in. Vasky back forth to spin it around the boards, and it's chipped out up the left side by McInnes. He has help from Green, but he couldn't get the pass across. Now he takes a shot that misses the net. McIver stopped that pass across as Travis Green was heading to the net. Now the Penguins back on it. Here's Jagr skipping through center over the line. Sweeney held him up, and Vasky got the clear.
Good penalty killing for the Islanders so far. Spreading out, keeping the puck on the perimeter. Lemieux trying to get it ahead to Jagr.
Soderstrom out to handle the puck. Into the corner it goes. Number 20 is Bob Sweeney for the Islanders. But it's Lemieux with the puck. Out to Dmitry Mironov. Now to Lemieux again. Ron Francis tried to gun across ice. Sweeney broke that up. Bouncing puck. Jagr center. That's eaten up by Beers. And Bob Beers gets the clear for the Islanders. 37 seconds remain to the power play for Pittsburgh. Penguins with the top-ranked power play in the league, looking at over 34% as they get the puck into the Islanders' zone. Sweeney got a piece of it. Beers gets the rest of it. And now it's Mironov back to get it for Pittsburgh. Mironov came over during the summer from Toronto in the deal that sent Larry Murphy to the Leafs. And now it's Matthew Schneider shooting it all the way down.
Pittsburgh also got a second-round pick along with Mironov from the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Penalty about to expire now. Closing seconds of the power play as Peter Nedved gains the Islanders' zone. Haslin took the drop and fired it off a deflection into the crowd. The Islanders have killed the penalty.
Dennis Vasky having a few words for the referee, trying to complain about something that not getting too far on.
There you look at Vasky, who, along with the rest of his remaining Islander defense mates last night, were really tested over the last 37 minutes when the ejections of McCabe and Severin got him down to 4D.
It's always difficult to play, but they did a good job with that. I think the coaching staff felt that under the circumstances, that was not the problem. Of course, if you get a goal or two, and I refer back, get Wendell Clark out on the ice again, his second shift of the hockey game, refer back to the fact that if you go into Philadelphia and only score one goal, you're not really going to go anywhere.
Well, Clark is back with Green and Bertuzzi. The Islanders just really now getting their second even strength shift of the game. Chris Wells, big centerman, number 10. He's 6'6", 220. Rookie for the Penguins, took the draw. And now the puck dumped into the Pittsburgh zone. Another giant, Francois Leroux, number 18. Handles the puck now at the Pittsburgh blue line. Green gets it back for the Islanders and curls it around the board. Clark misses most of that check on Joseph Bertuzzi. Reps one right through the goal crease. And it's Marcus Naslund, unable to clear the zone because Schneider knocked it down. But he had the stick over the shoulder, so they'll bring the faceoff outside the Pittsburgh blue line. Islanders have killed the penalty. Nothing's happening yet on our Hodel scoreboard.
Introducing the new, redesigned 2008 Ford Escape. It's a natural evolution.
And that's what it's like to be a spy.
Whoa.
Hey, kids.
Hi.
I'm Sarah's father. I'm not a spy or anything. My wife and I just own the Dairy Queen up the road, and I thought I'd make you all blizzards today.
Yeah!
He's making blizzards! How do you go on after that?
It's a tough act to follow. The new Tin Roof Brownie Blizzards. Choco-covered peanuts and chewy brownie pieces.
Hold on there, buddy. I got something to tell you. Even the best of us get dull after a while. It's time to change your blade. All us Fusion blades have an indicator strip. And when it fades to white, change your blade for a better shave.
Whoa!
Fresh blade, better shave.
You know, I can't count how many times I tried to quit smoking. Then I talked to my doctor, and now I see quitting in a whole new way. It was my time to quit.
Speak to your doctor. It could be your time to quit.
Look at you. You're exhausted. You're embarrassing yourself. You gotta eat something. You gotta eat, and you be strong. Here. Let her mama feed you. Munch, munch. It's good. Let her mama feed you.
Hey, Michalinas!
Friday on Real Classics.
Tea!
This is Norman Dale, our new coach.
Last time you coached was 12 years ago?
Oh, I keep forgetting there are only about 50 people in this town.
No school in this small has ever been in the state championship.
I've never met anybody who wanted to win as badly as I did. Welcome to Indiana basketball.
Gene Hackman stars in the Real Classic Hoosiers, only on ESPN Classic.
They might be stopping it. That might be all, ladies and gentlemen. Upset shot in this one, and I took time 22 years ago. I must be the greatest. I shook up the world. I shook up the world.
Bob Beers back in the Islanders lineup. He was here at training camp. You saw the IHL came in today. This is NHL career, 218 games.
The thing he's always been pretty adept at is helping teams out on the power play. He's got a good shot. moved the puck well, and presumably we'll see some time out there tonight when the Islanders have the man advantage. Right now, number 44, Ed Patterson for Pittsburgh, twists it around the boards. This is Richard Park getting it to the net. Soderstrom stops that. Penguins made a lot of changes during the offseason. They got younger, and they paired the payroll as well. They really got younger, though.
Did they ever? They dropped 3 full years. They were an averaging 28 years of age, and they went down to 25.
Now this is Richard Park, who is the second Penguin in the last few years to have been born in Seoul, South Korea. Remember Jim Pack? Played with Ottawa last year, L.A. and Pittsburgh. He's the other. Palfy drives one, and that's kicked out by Tom Barrasso. Palfy's got it back. Shoots one, and that one sails wide. Seamock was cruising around looking for a deflection. Now McCabe from the point. Guns one. It's slapped away in front. Never did reach Barrasso. And here's Ed Patterson with a left corner dump in. It's covered by Dean Chanel. In case you were wondering, no, the Penguins do not have a scout in Seoul, South Korea. Just one of the oddities that both Jim Pack and Richard Park were born there. Park played his junior hockey in the Ontario League at Belleville. That's Beers putting the body on the fallen Jaromir Jagr. Jagr gets up, centers one, past Francis, and now it's Dan Plott for the Islanders. Missing King with a pass. Derek has to reach back to get it, and the Penguins converge on the puck and gain the zone. Ryan Smolinski bounces it further along, but Derek King wings it around to the left side. Jagr cuts it off, cross-ice drive off the post. They score on the rebound. And the Penguins jump to a 1-0 lead.
Islanders trying to make that play around the boards, and they have to make it right. You've got to get it to somebody, but it didn't get there. Intercepted by the right defenseman of Pittsburgh. Take a look as the play comes around the board. Tough to pick up when you're a forward. And there's the defenseman, Mirdov, pinching down. Jagr to Francis. Bang. Into the short side. 1-0 lead.
And the most valuable player is Magic Johnson. 42 points, 15 rebounds, and 7 assists. He starts at center, plays forward and guard, and leads the Los Angeles Lakers to a world championship over Philadelphia.
DQ has a new tin roof brownie blizzard treat with chocolatey covered peanuts, chewy brownie pieces, rich chocolatey sauce, all blended with creamy DQ soft serve.
Sorry, got a thing for chocolatey covered peanuts.
It's exciting, the tin roof brownie blizzard.
Number 14, 21.
If your credit score is too low, you could be waiting a long time for a lower interest rate on home loans, car loans, even credit cards. So log on to transunion.ca now and get your credit report and credit score. No waiting.
Hey, Princess. All my number yet?
TransUnion. Manage your credit, manage your life.
If you think all batteries are the same, consider this. When even the firefighters have to get out, they depend on the T-Pass 3 communicator. And packed inside every T-Pass is the only battery they trust. Duracell. Trusted everywhere.
Who knows the most about beer? It's people who know there's such a thing as a distinctive Canadian lager. One that has real flavor and a refreshing taste. If you know someone like that, tell them we've got a beer with their name on it.
The Bulls have 3 seconds to try a shot and try to win the game. Sellers has George. George with 2 seconds to go puts it up. It scores at the buzzer. Michael Jordan has won it for Chicago.
Sometimes hard to understand when you ask a player, and you heard Wendell Clark, who was benched in the third period last night, about his feelings about being benched, and had you been benched before? I asked him that, and he said, oh, sure, many times. Over my career, I bet 6-7 times that I have been benched.
Sure didn't seem too terribly concerned with
no,
it.
No,
did he?
Didn't. He just seemed to, you know, the rest of the team isn't scoring either. It's really a team problem, you know, not mine individually.
I wonder, too, Ed, if the rest of the team gets a little subtle message that, all right, if this is one of the guys who's supposed to be leading us, so to speak, and he's benched, does that work as a message to the rest of the players?
Sometimes. It's up to the individual.
Kirk Muller for the Islanders, number 9, who has struggled lately as well. Tried a shot that deflected to Barrasso, so we get a whistle. And during this break, true Islander fans will be taking to the ice. Bud Ice. It's the smooth taste that goes down easy. Bud Ice, the official beer sponsor of the National Hockey League. Kirk struggled, Ed.
Yeah, Kirk Muller. And you can't always, a player like Kirk Muller, he's much like Ron Francis. It's not necessarily the numbers that they put up on the board. Their effectiveness is in so many other ways. Of course, his effectiveness, with the numbers that he's being paid, I suppose a lot of people feel that he should be putting up many more numbers.
Wonder, too, whether or not he'll see more time at left wing as things move along. Problem is, with a penalty coming up as Muller was taken down, the Islanders are starving for production from their centermen. I mean, they need Muller to play center, but is he at least as well-suited to play left wing?
Oh, yeah, his history has been one that he's a better left winger than he is a center iceman, but he gets cast into the center ice on teams where they need that kind of help. Montreal needed it. They need it here with the Islanders. Try to build a line around him. And Kirk Muller is, there's times I'm sure he feels that he would sooner play left wing with a good line. Well, I suppose some people, would take it to another dimension and say, the way things have been going with this contract deal, which we don't hear a whole lot about right now, but it has not been satisfied, is that he'd like to play left wing on a much better team somewhere else.
Well, here we go right away. Muller being roughed up a bit by Francois Leroux before they ever dropped the puck. Penalty was on Peter Nedved, which will give the Islanders their second power play. 14:04, the first period, the time of the holding penalty on Peter Nedved. So the Islanders for the second power play for them. They had 2 shots first time around. And now the linesman, Scott Driscoll, Greg Dvorsky, have everything straightened out, and they drop the puck. It's Muller for the Islanders. In front, King for a chance. Barrasso stops him. Around it goes to the far side. Simak taken down by Park. Play continues. Matthew Schneider trying to hold it in. Does so by smacking it around on the backhand. And then he got smacked around as well. A little slow to get up is Schneider. But the puck stays deep in the Pittsburgh zone. Muller plays it back to Schneider. But he couldn't get it deep. However, as it bounded back to the line, Muller protected it for a moment. But now it comes back out. And here's Simak gaining the zone. For Muller along the board. Now to Simak. In front for Schneider. And it looks like Barrasso got a piece of that. As it came across, Matthew Schneider was in close. Now Derek King in the corner. Out to Baski, the drive, Barrasso has that, and he holds on.
Much better power play for the Islanders. Some commitment by the players. They're taking some hits. Matt Schneider got leveled. Like a penalty coming up. Looks as though the Islanders, they're gathered around quickly. Going to be to the Islanders. C-Mac, Islanders on a power play. Minute and 7 seconds remaining on the penalty to Nedved, and Alexander C-Mac has now taken a penalty. Take a look as the Islanders contain the puck. Waiting for the shot. There it is, Barrasso. C-Mac got a stick in the face. And it was in retaliation that got him the penalty. You could see his head snap back as he was going to the net. 4 minutes is the penalty to Alexander Cimek. What else can go wrong? The Islanders, a miserable power play. They finally get it geared up. They get a couple of opportunities, and then Cimek gets a four-minute penalty.
Well, there was a minute seven to go on the Islander power play. So for that minute seven, they'll play four on four. And then for the remaining 2:53, the Penguins will have a power play. Meantime, the faceoff takes place with the Penguins controlling the puck. Richard Park comes up the left wing. Snyder hands him in. And now it's Vasky for the Islanders, taking a hit in the corner by Patterson, who in turn was hit by Snyder, and the puck's underneath Vasky. So we'll step out, still 1-0 Pittsburgh on the Modell scoreboard.
Hitter swings at the arm motion. Into deep left center for Mitchell. And we'll see you tomorrow night. It's the first time since 87 that we'll have a seventh game of a World Series.
What do you have, kid?
I saw your sign up front.
You want a job? I was thinking of someone a little older.
I can clean dishes or
kid,
mop.
Shouldn't you be playing hockey or something?
Well, that's what I'm trying to do.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name. And they're always glad you came. You want to go where everybody knows your name.
Kelsey's. Cheers to good food.
ESPN Classic is going hard to the net. Relive memorable playoff games on the very day they happen. Bitter rivals.
This is bad luck.
Great goals.
Gretzky with his body scores.
Great save.
Oh, my God, what a save.
Dominating performances.
He has been absolutely awesome.
And Game 7 upset.
Upset in the Mile High City.
NHL Playoff Classic. To the day, all month long, only on ESPN Classic.
Don't know jack about your credit? Stop clowning around. Log on to TransUnion.ca and get your credit report and credit score. TransUnion. Manage your credit. Manage your life.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
Apple Auto Glass.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
ESPN Classic is vintage cool. Call your local cable or satellite provider to order today.
Messier gets it away. Here's Fleury looking for his first goal of the series. Scores! Darren Fleury and the Flames are in seventh heaven.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the New York Islanders, and it's intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Islanders and Sports Channel is prohibited.
And make sure to catch the power, speed, and excitement of Islanders hockey by taking advantage of discounted full-season seats or great mini-plans starting with the 11-game ticket package. Why don't you call the Islanders ticket hotline right now at 1-800-882-ISLES. Representatives standing by as we speak. Capture the intensity of Islanders hockey at great prices. Call 1-800-882-ISLES. Representatives starving for your phone calls as we speak. And the Islanders starving for some goals right now. Well, how about Owen Nolan?
Yeah.
Colorado.
Wow, that's a big trade.
tell you what, Nolan, he was the first pick. It was the 1990 draft, which has been one of the real fruitful drafts in recent history. Owen Nolan was first overall picked by Quebec. Nolan, Peter Nedved, who's on the ice for Pittsburgh, was second. Then I believe Primo was third, Keith Primo. Mike Ricci, fourth. And fifth was Jaromir Jagr. How's that for a top five? And two of them are teammates now with the Penguins. Nolan and this guy, Jaromir Jagr. May very well be the best of the bunch. Stood up there by Vasky. And the puck comes back down. Wendell Clark chasing after it. Wendell Clark swung it to the slot. Nobody home for the Islanders. And Smolinski turns it up for Jagr. He's got help coming from Francis. Jagr goes towards the boards. Beers stays with him. And Bob Beers with a good play. Pushes the puck to Green. Quickly to Clark. Wendell Clark with a wrist shot that sails wide on the stick side. Islanders changing here. Get their defense pair on. Jagr carries in. Jaromir Jagr swung it off the skate of LeChance. And now it's Travis Green coming to center. And that harmless floater is gloved by Barrasso, but he gave away to McCabe. McCabe missed the net. Now it's Coffey trying to make a play, but Mironov got in the way of that pass. Now the puck behind the Pittsburgh net, driving after it. Marty McInnes, number 18. He's being draped as he pokes it in front. They score! Sema hanging out by the net while McInnes was doing the dirty work, was able to finish the play, and the Islanders now trail 2-1.
I think the word that you use, finish the play, two words, three if you have to, but anyway, I'll get excited if I want, yes. They finished the play, which was something they haven't been able to do in a long time, as harmless as it looks. Marty McInnes, I talked about him in the first period. There's Coffey, and he just poked at the puck. Well, why not? It's there. He hasn't got time to try and shoot it. Poke at it. Fighting off McIver, then Nedved. Look at Marty McInnes. Stay focused, and then a little poke shot, and the Islanders have a one goal. In their pocket, they trail by one.
Well, you know, three-word mantras. Coaches have them. Remember Red Holzman with the Knicks. It was, see the ball, see the ball. Mike Milbury probably screaming something to the effect of, finish the play, finish the play.
I was thinking just in the line of finish. Just finish.
Well, that's the key word. That's the operative term. Finish. Seamock did for the second time this year at 124. And the Islanders now trail 2-1. You got to give credit to Marty McInnes, too, as we mentioned before. And there's Dennis Vasky with a big hit on Tomas Sandstrom. So let's see if the Islanders gain a little momentum here from the early goal in the second period. In time, it's Mironov for the Penguins, spinning it around to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux, who can kill momentum as well as anybody in the history of this game, unable to connect with a pass. Coffey and McInnes on the assists for Seamock, second of the year at 124. And here's Peter Nedved with Lemieux. Lemieux to Sandstrom, back through the slot. Oh, the Penguins were covered by the white-shirted Islanders. And it's Kirk Muller for New York to Brett Lindros. Lindros, number 75, centers, and that's steered aside by Barrasso. Islanders with a little bit of jump now off of that goal. Are able to work the puck deep once again and force Barrasso to handle it. Laid it off the board. Lindros got that big body in the way to keep the puck down low. Muller's got it now. Muller in for a shot, but Barrasso stick to the side before Muller could really release it. Good aggressive play by the goaltender. Muller's got it back. Chris Wells harassing him. Muller keeps the leg churning long enough for Lindros to come in and help out. Now it's Muller and Lindros in the corner. Mironov, number 15 for the Penguins, with Wells of Pittsburgh doing the defending for the Penguins, and it's Wells trying it free. Now Marcus Naslund, number 29, checked by Beers. Following is Murray. Glenn Murray hit Beers with that shot. Naslund gets it back, but Beers flicked it away. Naslund once more now in the corner. Up the boards comes Marcus Naslund. Back down low it goes for Wells. First McCabe and then Lindros. Put the body on Wells and around to the far side it goes. Derek King spins it around the boards. Comes right to LaRue, and his shot was deflected wide. Rebound, Naslund, he put it in front. Sweeney breaks it up.
Good pressure by Pittsburgh. They want to get that two-goal difference back.
Now Brett Lindros keeps the puck deep for Sweeney. Clark cruising in front, but Sweeney couldn't get it to him. And the Penguins come out. Again, the Islanders changing on the fly. Joe Dzicic in over the Islander blue line. LeChance staying with him, and Sweeney turns it back up. Two Penguins back as Sweeney carries the puck to the Pittsburgh line. Up Sweeney centers for Clark, but Barrasso got a stick on it again. Al LaRue shoots out to Dietzek. Cross-ice feed is behind Park. Paskey steps up, plays it to Mick Fakoda. Right wing feed for Blunt, denied at the line by LaRue. A chance and Dietzek came together in center ice.
Team skating much better. Manstead getting in behind the hockey team. They want to see a little more action out of the hometown bunch.
Puck is at the Islander blue line, driving after it. Patterson, he was tugged at by Vakota, so Dietzek follows for a backhander, and Soderstrom stops that. Soderstrom was down, a chance taken down as well. Penalty coming up here, and a power play coming up. We'll get the penalty for you when we get back. The Islanders have a goal. They're within one on the Modell scoreboard.
Gretzky's still out there, killing the penalty. Here he goes after the puck. He's played all night. Wayne Gretzky in on goal. Just scores in overtime. Gretzky gets the winner. Edmonton wins 5-4.
A shorthanded goal.
This spring, zeros are everywhere during Mazda's Get It In Gear event. Zeros that tell you we're geared for our new economy with low financing on Mazda 3, Mazda 5 multi-activity vehicle, and the award-winning Mazda 6. With 0% purchase financing for up to 60 months on any new 2008 Mazda, springtime is the best time to.
Second stoplight. There we go.
So let's go!
What?
Things change fast when you're not looking.
Where am I?
Same with your credit. Keep an eye on yours all year long at transunion.ca. Log on now and get instant access to your TransUnion credit report and score. Where are you headed?
It's a cold, cold job, but somebody's got to do it.
Hey.
Frost-brewed Coors Light for that ice-cold, easy-drinking taste. Coors Light. Who wants a cold one?
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Wouldn't you like to get away?
Cheers to good food.
Friday on Real Classics.
Team!
This is Norman Dale, our new coach.
Last time you coached was 12 years ago?
Oh, I keep forgetting there are only about 50 people in this town.
No school this small has ever been in the state championship.
I've never met anybody who wanted to win as badly as I did.
Welcome to Indiana basketball.
Gene Hackman stars in the Real Classic Hoosiers, only on ESPN Classic.
Richard Park, youngest player on the ice tonight, 19 years old. Take a look at the action. Beautiful puck handling. Good stop here. Right pad saved by Tommy Soderstrom. And then the penalty. A little hook on the arm, pulling Scott Lachance off balance. So the Islanders go to a power play.
Park for the hook. And the Islanders, by the way, will have to do without Matthew Schneider for the rest of this game, at least. Aggravated some bruised ribs, so now will not return. So the Islanders to the man advantage. Sigmund Poppe, number 68, checked in the corner, and the puck hops over the board, so to keep the face off in the Pittsburgh zone as you look at Alexander Simak, who has the Islander goal tonight.
Big boost for Alexander Simak. It wasn't exactly a blistering shot. He didn't stick handle through the entire Pittsburgh team and then beat Tom Barrasso, but it doesn't matter. It's a goal. It's good for him. It's good for the team. cut the deficit in half, 2-1 early in the period as well, which kind of helps for the rest of this period and hopefully as far as the Islanders are concerned for the game.
Todd Bertuzzi will take the draw against Francis. Bertuzzi, Seamock, and Palfy up front, Lachance and Vasky on the points. And for Pittsburgh, the puck cleared to the line, but not out by Chris Tamer. Held in the corner now by Seamock, who centers Bertuzzi, but he's forced back behind the net. Now Palfy takes it back to the corner. Lachance at the point. Back along the boards to Palfy. Dickman, Palfy, a drive, and that sails over the net. Vasky couldn't control the carom. Palfy does, and that shot is knocked down before it can reach Barrasso. Cleared out of the zone by Ian Moran.
Good pressure by the Islanders. Maybe need a little more accuracy on the shooting. Make Barrasso stop those shots coming in from the point position, even if it is Palfy.
That is Vasky shoots the puck behind the Pittsburgh net. Wound around, Sandstrom couldn't control. Seamock jumped on it, then collided with his own man. That is Vasky. Then the puck ends up in the crowd.
Chris Tamer, the defenseman. What a story as you look at Dennis Vasky. Is he moving up the ice tonight? In forechecking, trying to take some chances, trying to get this game tied up, trying to give his hockey club a bit of a lift. A near collision with C-Mac as he came charging out of the Pittsburgh end of the ice, but Dennis Vasky putting a lot of energy into this game as he did the game in Philadelphia last night.
Now the Islanders have Muller, Clark, and King. Second power play unit. That's been a standard over the last couple of games with Beers and McCabe on the points. And it's Ed Patterson taking the draw and pushing it out of the zone. So the Islanders have to retreat now with 45 seconds left to their power play. 2-1 Pittsburgh. 2:46 to go, second period. LaRue just clocked Muller. And just about at the Pittsburgh blue line. Penguins clear out. That's about the second and third time. Remember on a face-off earlier tonight? Those guys were giving each other the business. And now Muller goes back after LaRue. They have subscribed to each other for the game, it would appear, at least from a physical standpoint. Wendell Clark chases the puck in the corner with Mironov. Around now to Muller as LaRue protects the net. Now he heads after Muller, who's behind the goal line to King in the corner. 10 seconds to the power play. Here's a drive deflected by Clark. It went wide. Clark has it back. Now to King. King throws it at the net, but it hits Lemieux, and that'll take care of the power play. As Clark comes out of the box, and the Penguins clear the zone. Richard Clark chases that loose puck with Bob Beers right in front of the Pittsburgh bench. Beers pokes it to the Pittsburgh line. Now LaRue takes it. And Francois LaRue flutters one down the ice. Chasing is Murray. Whips it around the boards. Held in. That then threw it at the net. Comes back to Chris Tamer. That one blocked by McCabe and the Islanders. Go to the transition game as King starts up ice. Soft dump in, forced the play offside, or at least Wendell Clark did not slow up, and so the play is offside with 12:34 remaining in the second period. It's 2-1 Pittsburgh.
Just by Hall, shot, Yarolenko, Hall, loose puck, Hall, jump, score, the Dallas Stars, Brett Hall, they've won the Stanley Cup, deep in the heart of Texas, the Stars are shining.
Saluton!
Either you go for it or you don't. Either you fall or you go on. Either you spin or you don't. Either you make it or you don't. You win or you don't. Either you grow or stay small. Either you break the record or you don't. Life is always action. X Games. Choose your action. Look for the official X Games product collection at Walmart.
How do you make your truck? Your truck.
$15,000 worth of no extra charge genuine Ford accessories and transform it during the custom truck event only at your local Ford store.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
Second period, Islanders trailing by a goal as Dean Chanel gets the dump in behind the net. Sweeney with a body check. Lott couldn't avoid one as he took the puck to the corner with Tamer. Sweeney sneaks in to look for the puck and comes away with it. Bob Sweeney now with Lott. This is Sweeney, number 20, from behind the net, looking for a play. Leaves it for LaChance. Islanders cycling, looking for some room here. Lott behind the net, trying to dig it free. Peter Nedved stepped in front of him, sends the puck up the ice. First to Tamer, and now on left wing to Noslin. Down the middle comes Moran. Noslin in for a backhander. He hit the goalpost. And play continues with Mott blocking an attempt by the Penguins to get it deep. I wonder if they'll review that, Ed. It came out more quietly. I didn't hear the ping from up here. Peter Nedved just took a hip check from Scott LaChance. I wonder if they might not review that as we get a stoppage eventually. Noslin's got the puck right now. Marcus Noslin turning in the corner. Noslin behind the net, trying to sneak it through. Soderstrom scrambles to protect it. I wonder if the Penguins will look for a review here.
Well, I haven't seen any indications. Generally, you'd see the players crawling all over the referee, or you'd see the coaching staff jumping up and down from behind the bench, signaling the players to do just that. But he got the goalpost. What a move. Noslin, as he undressed Scott LaChance here, LaChance committed too early. Noslin then to the backhand, through the legs, off the post. What a break for the Islanders. Wow.
Well, did get all iron, and Noslin knew it. As you look at the one-time number one draft pick of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Marcus Noslin.
Good skating. Shifty hockey player.
Native of Sweden, you know his idol was? Håkan Lund. Remember him?
Absolutely. Calgary Flames.
Yeah, won a Stanley Cup for the Flames in 1989. Soon thereafter, headed back to Europe to get an icing call here against the Islanders. And the faceoff will come back to the New York zone as you look at a frisky Marty McInnes, at least tonight, huh?
We've talked about it more than once this season so far, Howie. The thing is with Marty McInnes is his feet. He's an excellent skater. If you see him striding up the ice, you can always tell a good skater his feet are wide apart, which means you won't see him down on the ice very often. He's good balance. If he uses the speed, he gets to use the shot. And he also has a better-than-average shot.
Now, two-thirds of what was the kid line a couple of years ago, Green and McInnes are out now for the Islanders, along with Zygmunt Palfi. As that completes that forward unit, Brad Dalgarno, who is injured right now with a wrist problem, was the third member of that line that helped the Islanders get to the semifinals in 1993. And now you see the Penguins going offside at the Islanders' blue line as we get set to take a look at the Chrysler League leaders, which for this evening will focus on goal scoring in the National Hockey League.
There they are. Alexander Mogilny. Well, you'd say Vancouver. Wait a minute. He used to be with Buffalo. That's correct. Scott Mellenby. Wow, what a year he's having so far. His 8 goals, 4 of them are on the power play. And Brett Hull. He's having his own troubles with Mr. Keenan in St. Louis. Jagr and Sandstrom, both with the Pittsburgh Penguins, having excellent season so far.
Did all of those people under controversy come through for Pittsburgh for St. Louis last night? Hull, stripped of the captaincy, scores a goal. Howard Chuck, who had been benched and was part of the problem in St. Louis as far as Keenan and the players were concerned, scored a goal. And Chris Pronger, who's been an unpopular guy in St. Louis because he had the nerve to be acquired in exchange for Brendan Shanahan, the trade engineered by Mike Keenan, he got a goal last night for the St. Louis Blues. They beat the Hartford Whalers. Right here, just about midway through, it's the Penguins 2 and the Islanders 1. Penguins getting both of their goals in the first period. Alexander Simak getting the Islanders on the board at 1:24 here in the second. And again, if you're just joining us, Matthew Schneider out for the game after aggravating a rib injury. So the Islanders down to 5 defensemen, which seems like, I'm sure, a bundle of riches compared to last night when Mike Bilberry went down with 2-4 defensemen when Severin was tossed out of the game along with Brian McCabe. Two of those defensemen who are in tonight, Bob Beers just up from Utah, and also Dean Chenault, have not seen a whole lot of time, at least in Beers' case, not here with the Islanders. This is Brian McCabe, number 4, gunning the puck off the boards. Tamer for Pittsburgh sends Thomas Sandstrom in. And it's Sandstrom flipping it along the boards. Lemieux couldn't hold it. And Vakota takes it back, pokes it ahead to Muller. He couldn't find Bertuzzi. The touch by Barrasso negates an icing. Hit on the play is Vakota. Put the body on Moran. Now Muller a shot. Barrasso stopped that. Bertuzzi behind the net. Great by Lemieux. Vakota is involved in front with Chris Tamer.
Tamer is no slouch when it comes to fire them, Howie. This guy lives just outside Detroit in the summertime, and he spends a lot of the summer going into the inner city and working out in a gymnasium. So he takes good care of himself physically in the offseason, prides himself in the fact that he is very good with his fists. As a matter of fact, they were playing against Chicago a week ago, and he took on Probert and did quite a number on Bob Probert. He's also the guy they were playing against Los Angeles, their last game, and I guess he decked at center ice. He flattened Gretzky with a beautiful open ice check, and nobody went after him.
Tamer and Vakota, 5 each for fighting at 10:46 as they take their 17 career goals combined and cool off in the penalty box for the next 5 minutes.
Yeah, but Mick has 12 of those, doesn't he?
Well, Bertuzzi put down in the corner and a penalty coming up to the Pittsburgh Penguins. The Islanders will have a power play, but now things start to escalate a little bit. Wells, another big boy imported by Craig Patrick over the last couple of years. He was their first round draft pick in 1994. He goes 6 feet 6 inches tall, 220 pounds. The initial penalty was against Pittsburgh. We'll see what else develops when we get back. 2-1 Pittsburgh on your Modell scoreboard.
Landing these. Oh, nice uppercut by Buster Douglas. Look at this. He's knocked Mike Tyson down for the first time in his career. He's not going to make it. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
What if rates go up or down?
What if both kids want to go to university?
Your plan can cover all that.
And what about the kitchen renovations?
You could afford that.
New cabinets.
A pantry.
Marble countertop.
Granite countertop.
How about a breakfast nook?
Samaluji's nook.
Couldn't he name me that you find here?
No. We're not nook people.
So, no nook.
A Scotiabank advisor can create a plan that helps you get the upper hand on your home financing. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and one of my students, Sarah,
Dad, look,
noticed that the chip had become a crack. Hi, Sarah.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh, right across the driver's side.
You know what? Bring it by my store. We'll take care of it. It's just not safe to drive like that.
That would be great.
Hi, Dad.
Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
To make your walls rock, just roll on new Beauty Tone Flex Rock. Only at Home Hardware and Home Hardware Building Center. Use Flex Rock on drywall or painted surfaces. There's no priming necessary. Create the look of marble, old world plaster, suede, and more. Flex Rock hides imperfections, comes in 36 designer colors, and it's incredibly tough. Pick up easy to use Beauty Tone Flex Rock. Only at Home Hardware and Home Hardware Building Center.
Help is close to home.
How does the woman who works in a cosmetologist's office treat her wrinkles? This one uses Regenerist. New Regenerist Fill Plus Seal Wrinkle Treatment. It's not surgical results, of course, but it transforms your skin by filling inside creases and then sealing them at the surface. This filler does the job. New Olay Regenerist for Fill Plus Seal. Love the skin you're in.
Friday on Real Classics.
Team!
This is Norman Dale, our new coach.
Last time you coached was 12 years ago?
Oh, I keep forgetting there are only about 50 people in this town.
No school this small has ever been in the state championship.
I've never met anybody who wanted to win as badly as I did. Welcome to Indiana basketball.
Gene Hackman stars in the Real Classic Hoosiers, only on ESPN Classic.
You're wondering how many penalty minutes does Mario Lemieux have this season? He just got his second penalty for 4 minutes. A boarding penalty on Bertuzzi. Whoa, I guess so. Shame on you, Mario. And Bertuzzi gives Mario a shove back, says, don't do that. Who do you think you are? And then Joseph takes a little punch at Bertuzzi. So the Islanders, the extra man.
Well, listen, that combination, Mario Lemieux and Todd Bertuzzi, have now combined for 500 goals in the National Hockey League. Wendell Clark with a shot and a stick save by Barrasso. The puck to the crowd. Of course, Lemieux has the majority of those 500. 498 for Mario. Two more, and he's a 500-goal scorer as you look at Wendell Clark.
Quick shot by Wendell Clark on the power play. Did Barrasso get it? Here's the faceoff. The Islanders win the draw. Kirk Muller. There's LeChance, deflection, Muller to Clark. There is a rising shot.
And there's another one from Clark, and that's deflected over the net and slammed down the ice by Moran for Pittsburgh. Minute 40 to go to the power play. The Islanders have LeChance, who's got the puck now, and Vasky manning the points. Muller, Bertuzzi, and Clark are the forwards. That pass goes astray. That's exactly what Ed's been talking about for the last couple of nights. On the power play, not making that smart pass, the effective pass, to get him into the zone.
So important. You've got to put it on the player's stick. It's just a fundamental of hockey. That pass up to Clark on the tape.
Bertuzzi trying desperately to straddle the line and stay onside is unsuccessful. It's a pretty good way to pull a muscle.
You know, there really isn't. That's not coaching. You can't do anything about that. And most of that is just that the players are over-anxious. They haven't got the patience. They've got to be more patient. And young Todd Bertuzzi, trying to get a jump, trying to get in behind the penalty killers. Just a little too anxious. And how do you fault? If you know it, Mike Milbury, how do you go down the bench and say, you know that that young fella is just trying to do the right thing, and he just doesn't know how to be patient enough. Just don't race up to that line. Move up to it quickly. Just hold your balance. Let the play develop across the line instead of charging up the ice.
Presumably, and that's the operative word, it comes with experience. But I would think there are a lot of coaches who have been driven batty in this year by players who possess enormous amounts of skill and whom you expect over the first couple of years of their career would pick up certain basic fundamentals and adjust to them, who just never do. And that's the mystery for a coach, I'm sure.
Well, it is. And when you're talking about scoring goals, goal scorers have to be patient. A good example would be if you watch Lemieux. I was pointing that out in the first period. He just cruises around. He just doesn't overextend himself in a lot of ways. He's always thinking, always watching. He doesn't waste himself, but he moves in at the right time to pick up a loose puck or to get into a spot to get a pass. And he never overextends himself that way.
Travis Green now drops it for Beers. The puck, and they score! A power play goal, and the Islanders have tied it at two.
Zygmunt Palfy, what a good shot he just made. He got the puck and did the right thing. I talked to him before the hockey game because you'll remember in the game last night, three different times, he passed the puck when you were expecting him to shoot it. And he said, you're absolutely right. You've got to know that tonight, if I get the opportunity like this, I'm shooting. and it pays off. The Islanders have tied the hockey game. They have a power play goal.
Zygmunt Palfy finishes. That's the word we talked about before, Ed.
Well, you were talking about Bob Beers brought up here for several reasons, and one of them was to help the power play, and it was his pass to Zygmunt Palfy that paid off.
So Palfy's second from Beers and Green at 12:43. Gets the Islanders even. Got the chance number seven behind the Islander net, but we get a whistle for an offside. So the Islanders, who have not been terribly resilient this year, but on three occasions now have come back from two-goal deficits. Remember the opener in Boston, the game in Florida, they were down 3-1 and came back to tie. And now tonight have climbed out of a two-goal hole. They haven't finished one of those comebacks by winning yet, so there's another context for the word or term, finish. The power play goal by Zygmunt Palfy. It's the Islanders tied, and here's Bob Sweeney with block. Sweeney the shot, deflects off the goalpost. Back to Lachance at the right point. Unable to hold it in, but now protects the puck and works it deep. Ian Moran back to play it behind the Pittsburgh net. Now to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux had his passing lane clogged by Simak. Lemieux gets it back. Centering feet flicked away by McCabe. And now it's Lindros for the Islanders. Up the middle, that went through about four legs and ends up in the Pittsburgh zone. Francois Leroux chased by Simak, who finishes his check. That's Francois Leroux in English. As Ian Moran chips the puck deep into the Islanders zone. Nedved first on it, but the Penguins changing. No danger in front of the net, so the body check wipes out Nedved, and now Lindros carries the puck. But the sneak it past McIver, Jágr, and McInnes tussle. As it continues to bounce around in the corner, Jágr comes free with it. Out of Francis, rink wide, McIver gains the Islanders' zone. Or McIver behind the net, tried to hit the trailer. Simak busted that play up. That's a couple of times on this shift. Simak has read a pass. Here's Mironov floating one off a deflection, and Soderstrom just wants to scramble away from traffic. Let's take a ride downstairs once more and see what Stan Fischler has cooking. Stan?
Howie, I've been keeping a Wendell Clark watch ever since the start of the period. I'm right next to the bench. And to tell you the truth, I haven't seen anything encouraging in any way. He does not seem to be part of the chemistry of this hockey club. He had one shot. That was an automatic. But I don't see the kind of energy that the... Now he seems to be struggling very much. I question whether he really wants to play for this hockey club. Howie?
Stan, have you noticed any less of that tonight than at other times this year? I mean, had you noticed more of that enthusiasm from him his first couple of games here?
To tell you the truth, I don't see the kind of reaction that we expected from the stories in the papers when I talked to him before the game. I expected more verve. When other players get up on the bench in excitement, he seems to be sitting down. Now, maybe he needs more time, but he's not part of the chemistry yet.
I think that was one of the things that he was talking about in the dressing room before the game. It's just a comfort range that he hasn't seemed to find yet. And that may have something to do with it. I suppose 7, 8, 9 games is not a true test.
Well, there's a penalty coming up, I believe. Is that Smolinski who's going to go for roughing? I think this one's coming up to the Penguins. And if so, the Islanders will have the man advantage again. Don't forget they cashed in on their last power play, and it is Ryan Smolinski who's headed off.
So the Islanders, who have scored a power play, take a look. Vasky rides him in. Good job by Vasky. But look at him come back with a retaliatory move into the face of Vasky. And the referee, Bill McCreary, calls it. Vasky says, that's okay, I'll take that. As long as we get the power play. Just a good move. And there is a punch. Wasn't so much of a shove, it was a punch. Now Palfy is sent back to the Islanders bench. A little late on the change by Coach Mike Milbury. So Brian Trotche, there he is. Dark jacket with the headset on the left side of your screen. Always a welcome sight, particularly here, I suppose, having so many friends in the Long Island area. Nice man.
Wendell Clark for the Islanders as they go to the power play for the fifth time tonight. They're 1-for-4 with 5 shots with a man advantage. Clark now in the corner. Wendell Clark, a wrist shot. Stopped by Barrasso. Bertuzzi and Green together behind the net now. Spread out, as Mo Howard used to say. Green operating along the boards.
He's going to say how he wants to get the puck out where he's got it now in front of him so he can make a play, but that was a bad bounce to Scott Lachance. So many times power plays get the puck against the boards and they're back to the middle of the ice. They've got no play from there.
Meantime, good work by Ed Patterson. Enable the Penguins to chew on some clock there. And now there's 1:08 to go on the Islander power play. They're changing their forward unit. The Islanders are. So McIver plays it ahead to Sandstrom. Thomas Sandstrom works the puck behind the Islander goal. Lachance has it. 4:09 to go in the period. 2-2 the score. Derek King driving after the puck now. King driving to the net. McIver draping him. Good play by McIver to work it free. But a good follow by Simak. Now to Beers and then McCabe. Ryan McCabe, number 4, checked by Thomas Sandstrom. Sandstrom with a good move to get out of the corner without much opposition either from King and McCabe. And that gets the puck down to the Islander blue line. Sandstrom has had a real good penalty kill shift on the puck again. King gets it back. Now 25 seconds remain to the Islander power play. This is Bob Beers playing his first game of the season for the Islanders. Number 2 up to Simak, number 28. And to Palfy. Sigmund Palfy with a goal on the last power play. Feeds it down low, broken up, sent to the line, and held in by Beers. Now along the board, Simak. Checked by Yager, and then the puck comes out. McCabe has to hustle back forward to the Islander zone. Takes care of the power play. The Islanders got one lonesome little shot with a man advantage. Now here's a lead for Palfy, driving to the net. Sigmund Palfy wide, he scores! What a move by Palfy, who drifted wide and still beat Barrasso. It's 3-2 New York.
That was a deliberate move, Howie. That's a ploy that good puck handlers can move and do, and he is one of them. He's turned loose here. What a great pass coming out of the Islanders' end. Palfy got himself in the right spot. Derek King with that lead pass. Palfy will fake right here. Freezes Barrasso and then goes outside. You've got to be an accurate shooter in order to hit that narrow a spot in the net. But he could do it. If we stop the camera after he fakes, right here, stop it there. You can see the angle that he's got. There's not a whole lot of room as he drifts beyond and then lets it go. Even a sharper angle. Beautiful play by Sigmund Palfy, offside Pittsburgh.
Second tonight for Palfy, his third of the year at 17:01. It's 3-2 New York in the latter stages of the second period as you take a look at the revived Modell scoreboard.
The Leafs slowly cleared their own side. Sundin trying to go in. He lost the puck and it was cleared away to the center. Look out, they're up there again. These players are coming hard. Score! That is it. Jeremy Roenick.
To master the great outdoors, the pros choose Husqvarna for exceptional power, performance, and precision. Now you too can master your great outdoors with professionally proven Husqvarna. Find your servicing dealer at husqvarna.ca.
Anna Ricketts, last one.
Pitch, dark, smooth, red. It's the last night of glory.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name. And they're always glad you came. You wanna go where everybody knows your name.
Kelsey's. Cheers to good food.
Some women get lifts or peels or injections. Then there are the women who use Regenerist. Not for surgical results, of course, but for eyes that look brighter, younger. It works on age spots that seem to disappear. and gives you skin that looks beautifully regenerated. For women who prefer not to be poked or prodded, Olay Regenerist. Love the skin you're in.
To be the master of your great outdoors, there's only one place to turn. For professionally proven equipment, expert advice, and service, your Husqvarna servicing dealer. Find your servicing dealer at husqvarna.ca.
ESPN Classic is vintage cool. Call your local cable or satellite provider.
Sigmund Pulte is back. He'd say, well, listen, I haven't gone anywhere. What are you worried about? Well, anyway, the Islanders, 3 goals in this hockey game so far. They trailed. 2-0, and they now lead 3-2.
King, who gave him the headman pass, gets the first assist. Simak has had a real good night, the second. So the Islanders, for the first time this year, have scored 3 goals in one period. Now they're just trying to protect their net right here with the Penguins starting to buzz a little bit. Peter Nedved in the corner floats one right through the slot. McKinnis has it. 2 Penguins back. McKinnis lost the handle. And that allows Moran to step up and chip it over the boards into the Islander bench as you look at Marty McKinnis.
Well, we're going to take another look at the goal that Sigmund Pulte just scored. His second of the hockey game, third of the season. Question is, does Barrasso get a little of it? There, you see him faking. Barrasso committed. There's the shot as it's heading for the net. Woo, yeah. It looked like it hit the blade, right out on the tip of the blade, but there's no power. At that point, Barrasso couldn't hold the stick tight enough to keep the forward motion of the puck from going anywhere but where it was aimed, and that was in the net.
Well, if you're tracking those dueling Czech 68s, Jágr with a couple of assists, Pulte with a couple of goals. The Islanders, with a rarity for them this year, they have not led for a whole lot of time. 3-2, but here comes Noslin over the line, driving, and that one stopped in front. Soderstrom slid out, McCabe protected the net, and Muller carries the puck. Muller thought about shooting, had his stick tied up from behind, and the Penguins break back. Aslan de Lemieux, and now Noslin again. To Marinov, Soderstrom stops that, but Sandstrom scores on the rebound as Soderstrom could not protect the puck.
Just got to say, you do not want to open up and get a wide-open game going with the Pittsburgh Penguins. Too much firepower. Guys like Thomas Sandstrom, Mario Lemieux, who will get an assist on this goal. Just too much. At the other end of the ice, the Islanders had an opportunity. Muller, check from behind, and then look at the transition. A good example. Mario Lemieux, drop pass Naslund, then a good shot. Sandstrom is able to tap it into the short side. It was Sandstrom who checked Muller. There was the shot, and up high from Mironov, and Sandstrom taps the rebound in, and quickly it's a 3-3 tie.
Well, from the draw, Wendell Clark sweeps one rink wide to Bertuzzi. In over the Pittsburgh line, headed to the net is Green for the deflection. He scores! Travis Green went to the net. Bertuzzi found him, and the Islanders regain the lead. It's 4-3 New York.
Early in the hockey game, you're wondering if the fans were going to have something to cheer about. Well, they're getting it. Wow, these Islanders are stepping it up. They have opened it up. Do they want the shootout? Eddie Johnson says, well, wait a minute. We just get the game tied. Bertuzzi fighting off a check. A one-handed pass deflected by Travis Green. He's taken over by Ian Moran, but but the puck was in the net. Bertuzzi with a one-handed pass. Look at the deflection of beauty by Travis Green, and the Islanders have regained the lead 4-3.
Two goals in 10 seconds between Sandstrom and Green. Three when you figure Palfy's second one in a minute 27. But as Eddie said, you don't want to open the game up against a much more explosive Pittsburgh Penguin team. But it's 4-3 New York. Ryan Smolinski centers for Jágr. That's deflected away. Jágr spinning on Vasky. Jágr out the other way for Smolinski. He couldn't get the puck through some traffic. And here's Bertuzzi for the Islanders. In over the line. That one deflected by the stick of Tamer. And into the crowd with 54.9 seconds. Remaining in the second period, that's Tom Barrasso, who has had to face a lot of rubber in the second period. The Islanders had 9 shots in the first period. They have 9 now, but the Penguins have been held to just 4 in this period as far as shots are concerned. But how about that offensive explosion by the Islanders in this period?
You had talked about the fact that they had not scored 3 goals in a period. Now they have been able to get 4. Travis Green talking with Wendell Clark on the bench. Todd Bertuzzi. Third goal of the season for Travis Green. You know, a whole lot of players breathe a lot easier when they start to put the puck in the net. Albeit Pittsburgh has gotten 3, but they're ahead. They came from behind. That's significant.
Now Mironov for Pittsburgh and Naslin, number 29. Here's Marcus Naslin headed to the net. Soderstrom stops that point. Naslin can motor. Vic Iver to Lemieux. That one off of Soderstrom's stick. And the Islanders start a rush behind the cave to the red line. It's behind the net. Mironov chased by Clark. They come together. King gets the puck. Now Sweeney. Chased by Sandstrom in the corner. They bump Vaughn in there to get the puck. Vaughn for the Islanders. Tried to throw it at the net, but it hit Mironov. Vaughn gets it back, though. And he's dumped by Sandstrom. Play continues. Fans want a penalty. King wanted a piece of Mironov, but missed the check. And here comes Lemieux for Pittsburgh. Mario Lemieux to McIver. Now to Lemieux. Sharp angle shot stopped by Soderstrom. What a great play by Lemieux, who got the rebound. Just no Penguin able to connect with it. Now Plott throws it at the net as time expires in the second period. The subtleties of Mario Lemieux, how it make him so great, but nothing subtle about this crowd reaction. They appreciate the outburst by the New York Islanders in the second period. That's the guy who got him the go-ahead goal, Travis Green.
Secret to what makes a beautiful room. It's the right design and the perfect colors. Colors that reflect who you are. Rich, luxurious colors specifically designed to remain beautiful for years. Designer Series paint with ceramic microspheres is more scrubbable, more stain resistant, more durable.
And now with every gallon of premium Designer Series paint, you get a bonus $8 home gift card to help with your decorating and renovating projects. Exclusively at Home Hardware and Home Hardware Building Center.
Everywhere you go, everything you do, you are the inspiration. Because a car is just a car until it's powered by you.
There we go.
So let's go!
What?
Things change fast when you're not looking.
Where am I?
Same with your credit. Keep an eye on yours all year long at transunion.ca. Log on now and get instant access to your TransUnion credit report and score. Where are you headed?
It's a fast game in the Wild West. Wide open spaces, wide open hockey. If you can't keep up, you don't have a chance. You have to be quick on the draw, fast on your feet, and sharp with your shot. My game, you need power, soft hands, and a big heart. I'm no ordinary Joe. Size matters. This is the way I play. This is my sports center.
Timlin. Nixon punts. Timlin on it. Throws to first. For the first time in history, the World Championship banner will fly north of the border. The Toronto Blue Jays are baseball's best in 1992.
The Islanders are in a bit different country than they've been for a good part of this season, going to the third period with a lead. In fact, if memory serves, other than the Montreal game, that's the first time that's happened. But here's Lemieux trying to change it, and he scores! And just like that, 19 seconds into the third period, the Penguins have tied the game at four.
Look out for Mario Lemieux, because he'll find the opening, and if they get him the puck, look out. He knows how to do it. He was talking about it before the hockey game. Well, he didn't have his timing. He wasn't scoring the way he should, but boy, if you get him the puck, you better not gamble on it. Beautiful pass, and through the legs, through the feet of Tommy Soderstrom. Bob Beers standing up. He gets in behind Brian McCabe, and bang, it's a tie hockey game.
So now Mario Lemieux is out to make a little bit of history. We may be in for some of it tonight. His next goal will be his 500th. And here is Jágr, unable to get one to the net. Just like that, the Penguins tie it. And now they buzz in the Islanders' zone, looking to go ahead. Ryan Smolinski or Francis behind the net. Francis springs off a check, keeps the puck. Ron Francis out to Moran. That floater is deflected wide right for the goal crease. By Jágr. Now Jágr with a tip. Deflects the puck around the boards, and Bertuzzi just gets it out of there. Moran being chased by Wendell Clark. Bertuzzi in there as well with Francis. And then Simak just decides to provide a souvenir for the fan here at the Nassau Coliseum.
Let's take another look. 19 seconds into the period. Mario Lemieux. McCabe. Stutter step, wasn't sure, got turned around, and Lemieux saw that. He just bolted up the middle and fed it through the feet of Tommy Soderstrom. Just that quickly. Look at here, Mario Lemieux in the lineup. That's how the Penguins act. 292 wins, 252 losses, and look without him. Wow.
Naslund and McIver, by the way, picked up the assists on that goal by Lemieux at the 19-second mark of the third period. Now it's Francois Leroux, number 18 for Pittsburgh, spinning it around the boards to Joe Dzicic. And he gets the puck out to center. Here's Peter Nedved in over the line. Ed Johnston plays with his lines a little bit. Centering feet, poked at, save made, and Soderstrom covers up. Glenn Murray had the deflection from right out in front of Soderstrom. Tommy Soderstrom able to keep hold of the puck.
Goal number five for Mario Lemieux. What an attack by the Pittsburgh Penguins right from the beginning of the period. And they continue. Good stop by Tommy Soderstrom. Finally gets a hold of the puck. Islanders scrambling to cover the open men of Pittsburgh in front of Tommy.
Tommy Soderstrom protected by the twine. For each faceoff, he will back completely into the net. I mean, his skates are behind the goal line. If he were to catch a puck in his glove the way he's standing right now, it'd be a goal. But of course, that's not the idea. The superstition, comfort level thing. Also checks out the angles. Lines himself up at the edge of the crease. Now we're underway. Wendell Clark for the Islanders backhanded it out to Bertuzzi. They've added an assist on the green goal to Wendell Clark. That's the one that put the Islanders in front 4-3. In the latter stages of the second period. Wendell Clark. Clark had not scored a point for the Islanders in his last five games. Finally comes up with one there, getting the second assist. Right now, 2 minutes and 10 seconds have gone by in the third period. Lemieux to Naslin. Marcus Naslin left it behind the net. Sandstrom takes it out, whacking away at it. Finally, Travis Green gets Sandstrom off the puck. But it's Lemieux behind the net, trying to find Sandstrom again. And he does for a centering feed. Soderstrom's got that as Naslin sprung free for a scoring chance.
What a great effort by Naslin. What a stop by Tommy Soderstrom with his catching glove that time. Mario Lemieux battling behind the net. He was not facing up the ice either. He just made two attempts, finally got it to Sandstrom. There's the pass to Naslin in front. Wow! Awkward looking, but he got the job done. Naslin trying to reach it into the top of the net.
He's wrestling a little with Zygmunt Palfy there. It's not as though no one even touched Naslin. He was able to shrug off the vigorous attempt of Zygmunt Palfy.
Timeout been called. Mike Milbury is not afraid to take his timeout whenever he feels that the club needs it. And right now, with Lemieux scoring 19 seconds into the third period, and Pittsburgh putting on a drive to try and regain a lead that they had back in the first period. Mike Milbury, come on, guys, settle down. This is not the game plan we talked about. And what he's saying there with that gesture, it would appear to me, is that you're all running wherever the puck is. You're forgetting about the loose men left open. So let's take a look at an MCI proof positive replay, and that's the last save. Lemieux behind the net. 17 is Sandstrom. Lemieux tried to get it to him, taken away by Green, but Lemieux tries again. He's successful, and then Naslin with that chip to the top of the net, stopped by Tommy Soderstrom, a beauty.
So again, Mario Lemieux now is cruising for his 500th goal. The only player who has scored number 500 against the Islanders was Lanny McDonald, who did it in his final season. That was his final goal, if I remember right. Didn't he quit with exactly 500?
Exactly.
1989, and then Mike Bossy and Brian Trottier each scored their 500th career goals as members of the New York Islanders. Trottier, of course, behind the bench tonight with your old pal Eddie Johnston and Rick Kehoe. Ed Johnston, the former Boston Bruin goaltender, now the head coach of the Pittsburgh Penguins. And as Vasky got a piece of that puck, and then it's chipped out by McInnes. Imagine this, in an era when teams now carry 2 and 3 goaltenders. And if you look at Sima, checked in the slot. Francis has lost his stick, and he's trying to tie up McInnes. McInnes moves the puck to Sima. Sima goes to the corner, then it's tripped up. Play allowed to continue. And Yager's got the puck. Of course, nowadays, everybody's got 2 and 3 goalies. Ed Johnston, the last goaltender to play every minute of his team's game that season. You were with that Boston Bruins club.
70-game season, he played every game.
Back in 1963-64, he was just a young pup. That's, what, fourth year with the Bruins then, I guess?
Yeah, third year, yeah.
Francois Leroux at the left point sails it behind the net. And it gets caught on the twine long enough to necessitate a face-off. So we'll step out with the Islanders and Penguins all even as you take a look at the Modell scoreboard.
Traps it. Here he goes. Bidding for one. Here's the clear. Here it is. He scores! Hextall scored a goal on the empty net.
This is the first time in my 40 years being around this game that I've actually seen a goaltender do that.
How do these rotors work again?
Regular grab like this. But the superior ones grab like this.
Honey, I just...
Introducing Ate Premium One rotors. Their elliptical grooves channel away heat, dirt, and water for better performance. Plus, they increase brake pad life and act as a wear indicator, so you know when to replace them. Automotive safety starts at Canadian Tire.
Lease a 2008 Suzuki Grand Vitara with four-wheel drive, V6 power, air conditioning, and more for zero money down and $329 a month.
If you can't believe this offer is actually happening, please follow these simple instructions. Now then, let's try again.
Lease a 2008 Suzuki Grand Vitara with four-wheel drive, V6 power, AC, and more for zero money down and $329 a month.
Rickets. last one.
Rich, dark, smooth, red. It's the last pipe of glory. Lula, Victus, Lula, Dickens, Red. The rich, the dark, the smooth, Dickens, Red.
Keg's ready.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow go straight to my lover's heart. For me, nobody but me. Cupid, please hear my cry and let your arrow
lose yourself in a teen burger. Only at A&W.
Friday on Real Classics.
Team!
This is Norman Dale, our new coach.
Last time you coached was 12 years ago?
Oh, I keep forgetting there are only about 50 people in this town.
No school this small has ever been in the state championship.
I've never met anybody who wanted to win as badly as I did.
Welcome to Indiana basketball.
Gene Hackman stars in the Real Classic Hoosiers, only on ESPN Classic.
Loop shot into left. Here comes Conine. He can't get it. He's throwing home. Snow trying to score. The tag. A collision. He is out at home. The upset of the 2003 postseason.
There's one of the two number 68s in the hockey game tonight. Jaromir Jagr assisted on both of the first two goals of the game, scored by Pittsburgh, one by Francis, the other by Lemieux.
Crowd tonight of a little more than 8,300 here at the Coliseum, but the remaining 8,000 or so empty seats are in on a pretty good hockey game. A lot of people missing a real good one here tonight at the Nassau Coliseum with the Islanders and the Penguins in a 4-4 tie. As Dan Plott for the Islanders comes in across the Pittsburgh line, hemmed in by Murray, and Chris Joseph takes the puck now for Pittsburgh. And Murray and Smolinski have given the Penguins zero in that trade with the Boston Bruins that sent McKechnie and Kevin Stevens to Boston. Smolinski got his first point tonight. Murray's still looking for one.
And on the other side, Kevin Stevens is struggling. He can't seem to get the puck to go in the net. He and McKechnie both not doing what they were traded for to do on the Bruins side.
McKechnie's got 8 points, Stevens four, and they look great in comparison. Here's Muller denied by Tom Barrasso. Penguins have split their first six games into three equal parts. Two wins, two losses, two ties. Mario Lemieux slips it through Baskey's legs, but Baskey just took the body and stayed with him. Now Lemieux gets it back. Baskey with a check on Mario. Sandstrom to Naslund behind the net. Naslund has taken Peter Nedved's spot on this line. As Muller for the Islanders gets the dump in. Muller with King and McInnes, the Islander forward unit. Barrasso twirls it around the boards. Muller gets it back. Muller out of the corner, puts it in front. It hit Barrasso. But Chance with a drive that's blocked. And the Penguins go to work. Here's Lemieux. Over to Mironov. Dmitry Mironov. Mironov has it behind the Pittsburgh net. Islanders get Green, Bertuzzi, and Clark out as their forward unit. Bob Beers, number two, up for Clark. Wendell Clark over the line. Snaps one off of Tamer, then follows centers all the way to McCabe. That one is blocked, and the Penguins come back. One Islander back. McCabe hustling back in as well. Jagr missed Smolinski with a pass, and Travis Green heads up the other way. The Penguins are back pretty well. Green to McCabe. Try to get it to Bertuzzi too far, but Bertuzzi just chipped it over to Green. Now to McCabe. The drive, the deflection, stopped in front. Jagr's got it. Penalty coming up to the Islanders here. Now Bertuzzi wrestled down. The whistle blows. An interference penalty coming up, but it looks like it's going to be against the Islanders as the Penguins had control of the puck long before the whistle blew. Are they going to call it the other way?
I was going to argue with you at first. I think it is going to go to Tamer, who got the Islanders tied up in front of Tom Barrasso.
I think you're right.
Tamer going to the penalty box. I believe, Howie, that the Pittsburgh Penguins had come racing out of their end of the ice with the puck. Tamer had interfered with the Islander player at the goal.
Well, I'd love to count how long. I think it was Yager who had the puck on a stick and started the rush, had the puck before the whistle finally blew.
Well, an opportunity here for the Islanders.
I should say until an Islander was able to take control.
Kamer in the penalty box. 13:38 remaining. Looking for Bertuzzi. Just took a hit twice from behind. There's his hand in the air. He's watching to see whether or not Kamer does anything else. Meanwhile, Pittsburgh is racing up the ice with the puck. He was rather late, you're right, calling it. But his eye was on what Kamer was doing to Bertuzzi, who was face down on the ice.
So it goes as a power play for the Pittsburgh Penguins. They're 1-for-5 with a man advantage for the Islanders, I should say. They're 1-for-5 with 6 shots on the power play. Hickman Coffey connecting with a man advantage. And here's Vasky up for a chance. Off the board, C-Mac chasing. Barrasso twirling it around. And it's taken back by C-Mac. Now it's Lachance, having one block and cleared by Ed Patterson. Well, Soderstrom fields the puck for Vasky. The Penguins changing, but the Islanders unable to get up in time to exploit the change, so Vasky just plays it hard around. C-Mac was spun around by Mironov. Fans wanted a penalty there. They don't get one, and McIver has the puck. McIver now up ahead. Lemieux's got it. Mario Lemieux testing Vasky. He pulls up and shoots, and a pad save made by Soderstrom. Left a healthy rebound, which is all Lemieux wanted.
That's what's so hard about checking Mario Lemieux. Vasky stayed right with him, stayed in front of him, but the long reach of Mario Lemieux and that great puck control creates a good scoring opportunity. I go back to Lemieux for another reason, Howie. Remember the first goal he scored back in the first period, and the long shot went through the feet of Tommy Soderstrom. And then he scored another goal at 19 seconds, and he put that through his feet. Now watch what he does here. Stops quickly and then fires it. Look where he's firing it. Trying to put it through the feet of Tommy Soderstrom again. You don't think for a minute that Mario Lemieux studies goaltenders and where the puck beats them? Twice he beat them through the feet. And he tried again. 38 goals, 61 assists in 51 career games against the Islanders.
Mentioned Mario Lemieux looking for 500. The fastest player to 500 goals in the National Hockey League was Wayne Gretzky, 575. Mike Bossy of the Islanders did it in 647 games. This is Mario's 605th. So he would be the second fastest to 500, and will be. He'll get it. Maybe even tonight. Still 12 minutes to go in the third period. But right here, the Islanders on the power play just for another 17 seconds. Wendell Clark to Bertuzzi. LaRue hit him. Clark follows. Wendell Clark. Now to McCabe. And that one missed the net. LaRue hustles over for the Penguins to clear the zone. And that'll take care of the power play as Chris Kamer is up. It out of the box. And the Penguins have killed the time. 4-4 the score. 11 and a half to go now. In the third period, Muller for the Islanders. Disconnected with a pass intended for Vakota. Penguins can't clear out, though. Bob Beers plays it down the boards. Gets it back now, but then Beers is checked by Dietzik. And the Islanders on the puck. McCabe at the red line. Just dumps it in, and the Islanders make wholesale player changes. 9 minutes coming up on the amount of time gone in this third period. Eric King went down, hit by Mironov. Puck comes around to the far side. Lachance jumps in to keep it deep. Scott Lachance trying to come around the net. McIver holding off Lachance, so Muller comes in to play the puck. Muller for the Islanders with Mironov whacking away at him. Muller staying with the puck. Now put down by Mironov. Vakota pinning it along with Dietzik. It squirts free to King. Eric King to Muller. Islander forecheckers keeping the play down low. Muller trying to get it to King and hit a skate, but King gets it anyway. Eric King trying to stick handle, could not beat a Penguin player. It was Nedved. Now the Penguins come up. Murray to Nedved. Peter Nedved, number 93, driving towards the net. Takes it wide. And now puts it around the board. Murray, watched by Lachance. Put down. Play continues. Lachance chips it to Plunk. Comes out of the zone as we approach the 10-minute mark remaining in the third period, tied at 4. Eric King for the Islanders. Tried to get it to the corner. As the Islanders were changing, Tamer gloved it down. That allows the Penguins to start a rush. Lemieux gains the zone. Mario left it in the slot. Lott got to it. Noslin's got it back. A sliding block by Beers. Bob Beers has played pretty well.
He has. I was just going to say that, Howie. Beers has played himself quite a game. He's probably won himself a job.
But here's Mario. Denied. The rebound comes behind the net. As Lemieux, that close to number 500. The Islanders get it down the ice. They'll take an icing here. Stamer comes back and makes the touch. 9:26 remain, third period of a 4-4 tie on your Modell scoreboard.
A fly ball to Andre Dawson and deep. Dawson to the track, Dawson to the wall. It's gone! Home run by Rick Monday, and the Dodgers go wild.
Decorating or renovating? Use Homeworks home remodeling software and see how the job looks before you start, using actual photos of your home. Approved by the Canadian Home Builders Association, Homeworks is available only at Home Hardware Building Center, and Home Furniture. Homeworks features more than 2,500 actual products and a $25 home gift card with a project purchase. Before you start, use Homeworks and picture the difference. Only at Home Hardware.
Help is close to home.
It's about taking the plunge. It's about nothing stopping you. It's about flying with no wings. About rising. About getting over your fears. It's about enjoying each and every spin, every turn. It's about enjoying every instant to the end. And if in the end you become the best in the world, it's only because you've been the best all along. X Games. That's what it's all about. Look for the official X Games product collection at The Bay.
Started in boating with your free DVD at discoverboating.ca.
Well, I wanted to quit smoking, but even with willpower, it was tough. Then I talked to my doctor, and now I see quitting in a whole new way. It was my time to quit.
Speak to your doctor. It could be your time to quit.
You know how they say nobody's perfect? Each and every game, I'm out to prove them wrong. I'm always reading the ice. Calculating percentages, covering all the angles. Out here, patience is everything. Never show your hand. Always call their bluff. And hope the odds are with you. This is my angle. This is my sport.
Zoom around a little bit, and they're going home.
We're talking about the fact that Mario Lemieux wastes no energy. He knows where to go, when not to go. We've got an isolated camera on him. Look at him, looking around, watching all the time, and look where he is. Unprotected. What a stop by Tommy Soderstrom. Just went to a timeout, come back. Eddie Johnson telling me this morning, you think we don't take advantages of timeouts? Now, Lemieux just had a long shift, and guess what? He's out there again. That's what he'll do with Mario Lemieux. Lemieux's had enough time.
Sandstrom scores right off the faceoff. Lemieux got it to Sandstrom. A one-timer beats Soderstrom, and the Penguins lead it 5-4.
Well, it just proved the theory that, hey, Mario Lemieux is in so much better shape now. He's so much stronger because of the year off. He's working out. He has a gym in his own house. Puck cleanly to Sandstrom, who beat Tommy Soderstrom inside the right goalpost. There's the draw, Lemieux, wham, just that quickly. So the timeout gets Mario Lemieux enough rest that he could stay out.
Eighth of the year, second tonight for Sandstrom at 10:36. And now the Islanders will have to play from behind, but we get a penalty as there was an interference indicated behind the net. We're looking at Bob Beers, who appears to be on his way to the penalty box, and Now the Islanders have fallen behind and will have to defend against the top power play in the league.
Look at Mario Lemieux. It was a second effort that got the puck. Look at him. He's just like a little kid. Who says that the big stars don't get excited? Are you kidding me? He's loving it. He said before the game, he said this morning, that he's never felt stronger, never felt better with the regimen that he's on physically and back playing the game. Thomas Sandstrom just as happy. His eighth goal, the go-ahead goal for Pittsburgh.
So the Islanders, who have had a lot of time on the power play, they had the last four, will now have to defend against the Pittsburgh man advantage unit. And here's Jágr in the slot. Vasky took it away from him. Jágr checked by Vasky, who clears the zone. So you got Jágr, Lemieux, Smolinski up front. Francis plays one point, McIver the other for Pittsburgh. And the Islanders try and kill the first portion with Green and McInnes, the forwards. Vasky and Lachance are the D. Marty McInnes spun around by Francis, tried to draw the penalty there, but nothing doing. By the way, the Penguins took advantage of that timeout, as you were talking about, Ed. That's an illustration of why this is more a three-line game than it's been in years, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. No, well, they... Eddie Johnson doesn't like to use anything but three lines all the years he played.
Here's Francis with a chance. He missed upstairs.
It was that kind of hockey, and he likes to go back to it.
On Francis now, plays it around the boards. Minute seven to the power play for Pittsburgh. Jágr gets it back to McIver. Tried to get it to Francis. The puck hopped over his stick. Francis gets it behind the net. Jágr to Lemieux. Mario tried to get it into the slot, but Chance flicked it away. Francis hustles. Keep the play alive. Jágr from Smolinski. Jágr, the backhander, he scores! A power play goal for Jágr, and the Penguins take a 6-4 lead.
Just under 8 minutes remaining in the hockey game, and they just cycle. They turn, they move. They see everything that's going on. He could have given it to Lemieux. The Islanders had him covered, so he took it himself. Jeremy Jágr to the front of the net. Look at the work by Francis just to keep the play alive deep in the Islanders' end. There's Jágr. Gets around a broken stick. Gets around Scott Lachance, and then a backhand shot past Travis Green. Watch Lemieux. He uses Lemieux as a decoy when he comes out. He's going to pass it, but he held it. Then he was going to pass it, and he held it. And then he just backhanded it in. Two-goal lead now for Pittsburgh. Two goals in a minute and 27 seconds. Jágr gets his seventh, second on the power play.
Scott Lachance actually got a stick on the pass that came across towards the left point, but couldn't get it out of the zone, and then wound up getting beaten by Jágr. And so now the Islanders down two as time becomes a factor. 7:47 to go. Jágr, and so now the Islanders down two as time becomes a factor. 7:47 to go in the third period, and it's Peter Nedved for Pittsburgh, dropping the puck back to Tamer at his own blue line. Up now for Murray. McCabe holds him off. McInnes has the puck, couldn't clear, and Moran bounces it behind the net. Murray roughed up by McCabe. Now Nedved gets the puck. Peter Nedved to Tamer. Now Murray. But it's Chanel, who has made just cameo appearances tonight. Getting the puck back for the Islanders. Didn't get it past the stick check of Nedved, who gets the puck back. Nedved whacking away at it, but McCabe gains control momentarily. Dietzik played the body on him, centered. Soderstrom got a piece of it. Now Moran's got it. And Moran to the corner. Turns it to the far side, and now Zygmunt Palfy for the Islanders lifts it out of the zone.
Then all Pittsburgh from the 19-second mark of the third period when Mario Lemieux jumped up and scored the goal.
Marcus Naslund loses an edge, and the Islanders come away with a puck. Two Penguins back as they just change. Eric King takes a hit as he gets into the zone, and the Penguins turn it around. 3-on-2. Naslund carries the puck. Now for Lemieux, and the pad save. The rebound sails over the net, and again Lemieux with a good chance at number 500. Noslin to Sandstrom. Now Lemieux, and he misses up high, and there was his best chance.
You think for a minute they're not feeding him, knowing that Mario Lemieux has an opportunity not only to have a hat trick, but to get his 500th goal in this hockey game.
In case you're thinking, well, would he rather get it at home? The next game they play will be in New Jersey on Saturday, so it'll be another game yet before the Penguins get back to Pittsburgh. Derek King behind the red line. Ducks one behind the net. Now the chase for it. Sandstrom taken down. Muller's got the puck. Sandstrom. Here now the Penguins come out 3-on-3. Here's Lemieux again. Mario Lemieux trying to part the Red Sea. Almost did. And it's King coming away with a puck. You set Espo up for any of his milestones, Aurora?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, you didn't get to play with Phil that much, did you?
No. I never did power play.
Here's LeChance with a drive, and that's steered aside by Barrasso. Susi. Cross ice for McCabe. McCabe throws it at the net, looking for a deflection. It's up behind the goal line. Travis Green finds LeChance. Now the shot, they score! Wendell Clark at the doorstep. That's in the rebound. 6-5, Pittsburgh with 5:13 to go in the third period.
A little more vintage Wendell Clark down, getting dirty in front of the net. Islanders handling the puck well, looking for Tuzzi as he stands off to the side, works his way to the front, stopped by Barrasso, fighting off a check from Moran. Boom. Francis doesn't like that. He breaks his hockey stick. Good play here by Travis Green to get it back. LeChance, low hard shot. There's the rebound. And it's in the net. Clark has his first goal as an Islander, 221st in the NHL. More importantly right now, for the Islanders, they're within one of Pittsburgh. They've got 5 minutes remaining in the third period.
Well, this could be fun if the Islanders force the issue and send them in from the back line. That could result in a couple of odd man rushes for this explosive Pittsburgh team. But it's the Islanders who have to look offense now. Down a goal. 5 minutes to go. They have the puck in the Pittsburgh zone. Here's Vesky with a drive. The save by Barrasso. And the puck back to the corner. Alexander Simak and McInnes behind the net. But it's Tamer with the puck. And now Yager comes out of the Pittsburgh zone. Yager to the Islander line. Austin on a stick check. Francis gets it back. Smolinski fanned on it. Pierce and Palfy got together on him. And it's Palfy unable to get it past Francis. And here's Yager. But the stick check by Vasky got it away from him.
Boy, you don't want that Yager guy. You don't want to let him get loose in the offensive zone with the puck.
Well, it's where the Islanders would prefer he stay, on the bench. As Bob Beers gets the dump in for New York. Barrasso twirls it around the boards. Could have given it to his defense. Didn't, but the Islanders can't hold it at the point. And it comes back to the Islander blue line. LeChance couldn't get it past Nedved. By the time the Penguins bring the puck back in, they're offside, so we'll step out.
Bullock turns with Ferraro. Here they come. 2-on-1. Bullock shoots. Scores! David Bullock! Islanders! And they'll be a new Stanley Cup champion in 1993.
Who wants the keys?
State your case, young man.
Well, we're doing our hockey pool, and some keys would be a nice touch.
A hockey pool and the pride of Nova Scotia is perfect. High five! Works every time. Wilson? Hey, Wilson, nice draft pick. Next time, why not try my glorious Red Amber Ale?
Hello, little boys, little toys. We're the dreams you'll believe in. Crawling up the walls, running down your face. Is the chance gonna move, gonna be? Silly boy, gonna make you cry. Now hold on to me, pretty baby.
Hello, Moto.
The Honda Drive a Winner event is on now, where every car's a winner. Get incredible lease offers on the award-winning Accord LX for just $298, or the 5-star safety-rated Odyssey DX for $328, or lease Canada's best-selling car 10 years in a row, the Civic DX with zero down for $198, and get 0.9% purchase financing on other selected models. Drive a winner. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
You've waited long enough to touch true beauty. See the new LG Touch phones at LG.ca.
You know, I can't count how many times I tried to quit smoking. Then I talked to my doctor, and now I see quitting in a whole new way. It was my time to quit.
Speak to your doctor. It could be your time to quit.
Well, I know that that's a skate. That must be water by the splash splash, and it's probably the Islanders' bench by the socket.
Here's McCabe for the Islanders, playing it in over the Pittsburgh line. Is it common to see that much water on the bench?
Yeah, it is at this point of the hockey game, Howie, only because the players, they don't drink it so much. They wash their mouth out with it and spit it out on the floor. Those rubber mats are there, of course, to protect the skates, and they collect the water. Mike Notary doesn't care anything about that right now. He's got to figure out for the next 3 minutes and 51 seconds how he's going to utilize some of the power that they have shown in this hockey game. And EJ, Eddie Johnson, is going to figure out how he's going to set his defense. Remember, I talked about it a couple of times, that the weakest part of the Pittsburgh team is in their own end of the ice. Defensively is where they hurt the most.
The Islanders have Muller, King, and Sweeney up front here with McCabe and Lachance back. This is McCabe, the floater. Stopped in front and swept out of the zone by Ed Patterson, wearing number 44 for Pittsburgh. Lachance, number 7 for New York. But a Sweeney who couldn't chip it out. Peter Nedved throws one at the net. Soderstrom went down. Piece of that. Lachance working with Patterson in the corner. Nedved couldn't get it past Muller. Kirk Muller for the Islanders, number 9. Whirls it around to King. Derek King gets it to center. Now Lachance has it back. Got the chance, tried to play it to Muller. Actually, Muller wanted to touch the puck but couldn't, or else it would have been a hand pass in the neutral zone. That's one of the reasons that play didn't work out. Derek King drops it to McCabe. Nobody home to receive that pass, and here's Marcus Naslund for Pittsburgh. Lost it to Beers. McCabe played it out. Time's a-wasting for the Islanders. 2:53 to go. They're down a goal, and here's Sandstrom, number 17. Now Lemieux, and there's number 500. Mario Lemieux has become the second fastest 500 goal scorer in National Hockey League history. It is 7-5 Pittsburgh. This is Mario's 605th game. Only Wayne Gretzky did it any faster. He did it in 575 games. Congratulations to number 66.
He's worth the price of admission, Mario Lemieux. You could see him dancing on his skates throughout this hockey game. They utilize his time perfectly. They know when to get him the puck, and he knows what to do with it. That's 500 career goals for Mario Lemieux. A hat trick in the hockey game. Thomas Sandstrom, as he turned, fed it to Lemieux, and wham. And you know where that puck went in? Between the feet of Thomas. Here's Mario Lemieux, 20th player to score 500 goals, and is just pointed out by Howie Rose, second fastest ever to Wayne Gretzky.
So isn't it fitting then that number 500 should go through the five hole? That's where Soderstrom has had some problems tonight. 7-5 Pittsburgh. Jágr looking for more. The slip pass to Smolinski. And he was looking between the legs too, but Soderstrom gets a piece of that. 2:22 remain to the third period. Pittsburgh reopened a 2-goal lead on the Modell scoreboard.
Is the entire city having lunch in here today?
What are you doing?
Playing a game?
I'm making revisions to this morning's quote and emailing it to the client.
On that? Well, personally, I like to relax when I have my lunch.
Oh.
I think they just gave our food to that table.
Very relaxed.
What?
With Windows Mobile from Rogers, now you can open, edit, then email attachments on the go. Choose from plans starting at $15 a month.
can you? You're exhausted. You embarrass yourself. You gotta eat something. You gotta eat and you be strong. Here, let Mama feed you. Mange, mange. It's good. Let Mama feed you.
Hey, Michalinas!
Because she'll need two more operations before her first birthday.
Because I have to have surgery tomorrow. Because parents should never outlive their child.
Because I need his heart to keep beating.
Because I don't want to tell them their daughter didn't make it.
Help. Whether you've never donated blood before or haven't donated in a while, you can save a life right now. Please book an appointment to donate blood today by calling 1-888-2-DONATE. Canadian Blood Services. It's in you to give.
What a great athlete, and he has returned full strength. Wow. Here's Sandstrom getting the puck back to him. And look at the head, always up. He knows exactly where he's going to shoot the puck, and he can put it there. He's so accurate. His third hat trick against the Islanders in his career.
32nd hat trick overall from Mario. Sandstrom and Naslund drew the assists on the historic goal at 17:12 of the third period. You see the clock in the upper left-hand corner of your screen, ticking away on the Islanders. Ron Francis with a chance to Smolinski, but Smolinski missed the net. Now he centers one right through the goal crease. Jagr's got it back. Jagr whirling. Jaromir Jagr drawing two players to him. Fell down. It's the best defense anybody can have against Jagr. Stare him in the eyes and hope he falls. Tamer behind the net with a minute 40 to go. And this one sent all the way down. Pittsburgh will be hit with an icing call as Lachance touches up.
What do you do when your team scores five goals at home and you can't get a half a loaf? Mike Milbury finally sees the offense break loose, but what has let him down in this hockey game is the defense. When do you get it to fit all together? Get them both going. Just about the time you worry about trying to get players to score goals. Boom, they let in seven.
Well, Tommy Soderstrom is still in the Islanders' net. Two goals down. We'll see whether or not Islander coach Mike Milbury decides to pull him for an extra skater if the Islanders can keep the puck deep in the Pittsburgh zone. That's where they have it right now, but it's the Penguins on the puck. Soderstrom staying put. This is Dmitry Mironov coming out of the Pittsburgh zone, hitting the red line. Now into the Islander end of the ice. Lachance has it back. And Al McCabe. Checked by Murray. We approach the final minute of play. Murray bounces off a check. Travis Green got a stick on that. And we're down to the 1 minute mark. Lachance for New York. With back of Clark's skate. So Wendell has to reach back, do a little pirouette before heading up ice. Wendell Clark takes it to the corner. Now to Bertuzzi. Todd Bertuzzi tried to get it to Green. Couldn't get the puck. Came all the way back to McCabe. Behind the net. Now to Travis Green again. 40 seconds to go. Muller rifles one in front. Clark couldn't get a stick on it. Pierce pinched. Doesn't get it deep. Soderstrom now on the bench. And the Penguins just poke it to the Islander line. So the Islanders with the extra skater on. Their net is empty. They're down 7-5. 22 seconds left. Muller walking in. Centering one. Sima couldn't finish. Around it comes to the far side. Pierce trying to keep possession. 13 seconds remain, and the Penguins have it back. Peter Nedved hit by Vasky, who stepped up and prevents Nedved from finding that empty net, but it won't matter. Final 5 seconds of the game, and the Islanders are going to go down to another defeat. And now it's official. 7-5 Pittsburgh, but the big story, that man, Mario Lemieux, is now a 500-goal scorer.
You could see by the way he was skating, Howie, in the third period, you'll remember, not only the goal he scored at 19 seconds, but again, just after that, he danced between a couple of the Islander defensemen, showing a lot of spirit, showing a lot of poise, and a lot of energy for a guy that gets as much ice time. It's been a long time since you've seen Mario Lemieux with that kind of jump in the third period.
What was bad news for the Islanders tonight is great news for the National Hockey League. Mario Lemieux is back every step of the way, and he's just scored a milestone goal in helping the Pittsburgh Penguins defeat the New York Islanders 7-5.
It's playoff time in the NHL, and ESPN Classic is going harder than ever. Relive memorable playoff games on the very day they happen. Great goals, great saves, Game 7 upsets, NHL Playoff Classic to the day, all month long, only on ESPN Classic.
You're watching ESPN Classic.